Hello Aquarius, welcome to my channel. My name is Donna Wilder Hart and this channel is Irish Donna Tarot. For those of you who have subscribed, liked, shared and left comments, I'm so grateful for all of your support. The channel is brand new. We just started posting regularly in November. So thank you for your support. This is a reading for the collective Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus of Aquarius. This is a reading. I will read it like a romance, but it could apply to any relationship that you actually are coming to the reading to ask about. So if I am running a contest, the details are below, my credentials are below, and it is a 20-minute free telephone reading with me. Let's get started, Aquarius. Let's see what we have. So we're going to keep the readings under 14 minutes, if at all possible. But if the story demands more, it is. Father of Cups is the energy. That is Scorpio energy. The Death card says that there is transformation going on in a relationship. Father of Pentacles. We have a couple of masculine energies here. It also shows many of you might be single. And it looks like you could have had an interesting but possibly stressful period of time recently. That's just energy, right? It's not events. So here we go. We're going to cut the deck and see what the mutual energy in the past in your relationship was coming into the reading. Okay, some difficulties here. The Four of Cups is an energy that says that maybe one person is disengaged and they tried to close you off, Aquarius. So I'm not fond of this. You know, a rat sitting on top of a wine glass to me says toxic, but I digress. The point of the tarot is to really learn from it, right? That's why we're here. So, oh, beautiful. The mutual energy now certainly shifted. Look at that. And when they first met you or at the beginning of the relationship, they were just in a toxic state. Oh, interesting. Beautiful. The Star card, that's about healing. That means that, you know, you've had a profoundly positive effect on each other in a longer term situation. This does look like it could be a longer term relationship. All right, it also shows the Three of Wands. Looking into the future, that's how your person sees you, Aquarius, as part of their future. Let's see how they view you. They view you as an incredibly hardworking person who's highly skilled, who really builds things in a very intricate way, that you weave this beautiful web. You look like you're delicate, but in actuality, you're very, very strong. People have no idea when they meet you what you're capable of, but those who are in the know certainly know. All right, how they feel about you in their heart space, the Emperor. Look at that energy. Toxicity to growth, healing. Oh my word. There is, I really wish I knew a bunch of Aquarius people that I could ask about this energy. This is really an incredible event that I see unfolding in front of me. The Emperor energy, that just means total mastery and manifestation of a masculine nature. It says basically this person wants to spend the rest of their days with you. They feel as though their life is filled with sunshine. That tree is very upright. It's very phallic in its look. It basically says, hey, I'm not going anywhere. I am planted thoroughly in your life. You are planted in my heart, and you have been the manifestation of everything I could have wanted. Oh, beautiful energy. In the future, the way they see the two of you going forward. Well, there are some challenges here. Looking at this reading, I'm not going to be overly bothered by this devil because it looks as though work, your focus on work and creativity is taking some time from the relationship. So your person sees the relationship a little bit stagnant right now, but again, I'll clarify that. I don't see this as, this mix of cards is very normal to me in terms of developing relationships where everybody's becoming fulfilled and doing what they need to do. All right, the hidden energy is equal, give and take. You are both in this to win this. This is one of my favorite cards. It's really beautiful. It's really a requirement. Look at how beautiful that is with the rosebuds. All right, let's look and see how you're feeling as the weekends, your thoughts, your feelings. Father of Swords, you are very much in your masculine feels. That is Aquarius energy. It says that you're very busy doing your creative, whatever it is that you're doing for work. The development of your life is very focused right now. Again, that can be devil energy, workaholism, but I'll clarify, like I said. But it shows that you feel a great deal of satisfaction. You are looking at your life from a very sort of like from the mountaintop looking down, Aquarius energy. You are here in your reading. I love that. You know, the beautiful star card is also Aquarius energy. You are really prevalent here on the board today, and I'm so grateful. Your outcome for your partner, oh, the Hermit card. They're spending time alone. Look at how cute that hermit is. That hermit's not even unhappy. That's a cute little hermit burning the midnight lamp for you, leaving the lights on for you to come back from your journeys out of your home. It does look like you share a home together. I just get that vibe here. Many of you do. So we're going to clarify this and see what is happening here in this beautiful reading. Aquarius, you guys are so competent, so capable, so smart. Let's see, what was this old toxic energy about? Okay, what was the old toxic energy about? And we'll see if it relates to the devil or not. But you know, we aren't perfect as people. So if we expect perfection, we'd never get to have a relationship, right? So we don't look for that. We don't look for perfection here. All right, so here we go. Okay, so why is the Four of Cups here for Aquarius? Why is the Four of Cups here? Okay, so at first, okay. Oh, it looks as though one of you just had a breakup when you came together. Your first feeling was that you would be friends. That was the approach. The Death card. Well, that didn't last long because we get that this person, you guys were never going to be just friends. That's kind of comical as I look at it because look at this. The masculine entity, the Emperor Aries energy is right there. That Aries energy had it for you day one. So it does show that there were hurt feelings. Both of you came into this relationship having had your feelings hurt before, in a prior situation to when you met. So again, oh, you're both rock stars. Why is the star card here? Why is the star card here? Okay. The star card is clarified by the star card. All right, I do see the Empress card here and the Father of Cups. So you are considering a family currently. I do think that both of you want to manifest this very abundant. But look at Emperor, Empress, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. One of you with the star card may also be pursuing an entertainment career, but you'll be a rock star in your chosen profession. The energy that of the Father of Cups is that you both really nurture each other. Beautiful nurturing energy. So that's, I love that energy. The Three of Wands, why is the Three of Wands here? That's looking into the future, the distant future. It also looks that you may be discussing where you could live, you may move. So it does look like there are some changes on the horizon. It shows Sun of Swords. It shows that you will use, you're actually investigating, you're doing research online, both of you. Your person sees you doing the research. They feel as though whatever moves you make are going to be very strategic for your future life together. Ooh, I like this. Okay, why is the Eight of Pentacles here? So that really, Eight of Pentacles is also when you go back to school or you learn something or you hone your craft. It does show that your person feels as though you're exhausting yourself. You need to take a break. You know, that's how they see you. They see you as working overtime. You know, it looks like you could even have two jobs or one very, very heavy duty job and the pursuit of manifestation of some goals that you have here. That happens, right? Okay, Eight of Cups, they feel as though sometimes they miss you. You're not gone, but it shows that they miss you. You know, we've got the little hermit card here. So your person misses you when you're gone and you're really busy. You know, that's a beautiful thing, right? You would want them to miss you a little bit. Why is the Emperor card here for you? Why is the Emperor card here for you? Ah, Three of Wands. Okay, but again, your Emperor is also plotting their future. Look at this. Look at this. And that. That's incredible. That is beautiful. And the Emperor's manifestation, the Empress's manifestation, it is a divine partnership. It is oftentimes a twin flame relationship. It does show right now that your person does not want you to, okay, so your person of interest is very fearful that they may get left behind. Okay. The Six of Swords says that sometimes they feel sad, they're down. They feel as though they're not getting enough time with you. But look at what they want. It's clarified by marriage. Ten of Cups, happy, happy. Manifestation of an absolutely beautiful marriage. They're just sort of feeling a little exhausted from the fact that you haven't had time together. The Devil card, beautiful. It's clarified by Temperance. It means that both of you are going to find your balance with justice, that your energy, that you're coming in with the Mother and Son of Pentacles. That's somebody who, I think you're the Mother of Pentacles because you're the one who's in charge of everything. The Son of Pentacles doesn't have any real choice, and that's your Emperor. I will say one thing. When the Emperor rules over the land, right, and all of the inhabitants of the land in which they rule, the Empress never gets ruled by the Emperor. She is a force of nature of her own, and this Emperor is smart enough to know that when push comes to the decision-making factors, he is a mere child at play if he were to challenge the Empress. Beautiful energy, you know, Mother Earth, right? Mother Nature is thought to be feminine, so there we go. You're a force of nature. Okay, equal give and take. It looks like right now one of you is probably doing more housework and more domestic duties, and let's see why else that Devil card is here. Why is that Devil card here? Nine of Swords. Somebody's way too worried, okay? That's needless worry. It's Gemini energy. Oh, Father of Wands. So I'm just feeling like the Emperor here is like worried that he's not doing enough, or he doesn't know quite what to do, and he feels frustrated because he doesn't really see the way that he can be the masculine entity in your life. It's like if a guy said to you, well, you don't need me. And that, you know, that's very challenging for a lot of men. I get the Tower card. They're very afraid that your pursuit of your career could cause a disruption in the relationship. The reality is, though, that it doesn't. There is no Ten of Swords here because this is really a situation where, you know, if you're out there and you're hitting a ball out of the ballpark, or you're a star, you're pursuing a very, very interesting time in your life, people get nervous. They're afraid you're going to meet somebody that you could betray them. But the Devil energy is jealousy and fear. And the Emperor feeling as though he isn't doing enough, giving enough, and yet knowing full well that he must allow you or the feminine energy to take the lead. There's no other way to do this. The outcome, of course, is quite beautiful. It is the Ten of Coins, a marriage card, Ten of Hap. This is a legacy marriage, an abundant marriage, a wealthy marriage. This is the happiest that you can be in a marriage. And it shows that you are still transforming. You're in your chrysalis. You're ready to break out, and that is your energy. Okay, so let's look and see. One more clarifier for the Father of Swords. This is a masculine energy of executive decision making, which also is Empress energy, and it is Aquarius energy. So that's my opinion. That's how very much I see this. You are very much waiting for some answers. It shows that you're a bit on hold at the present time. But you're very at peace with it. You're very at peace. You're not worried at all. It's just not time to make a decision. So going forward, the Hermit card. Why is the Hermit card here for your partner? Yeah, well, they want a new beginning with you. They're just waiting. That's so adorable. It's sort of like waiting with you, waiting for you with a little bouquet of flowers, you know, waiting for you, waiting at home for you, candles lit, making you feel very good, running a bath for you. buying you beautiful, maybe going to different stores and buying you beautiful bath bombs and just doing anything they can, because this is the emperor. He's not going to sit by and watch all that without making taking it under consideration. Aquarius, you have a delightful reading and a beautiful unfolding love story. I can't wait to keep up with you. And thanks so much for watching. Take care. If you like, please subscribe and comment. Thank you.